Hello and welcome to episode 7 of my survival. Right, today I'm listening to some Kevin Wilson, so enjoy the video and enjoy the music.
Too much of me time, buying dinner and wine, get me money on flowers and lollies, only to find that what's on me mind isn't on hers and she's sorry. So I've made up some lines that save wasting time and keep me from blowing me brass. I'm ever so cool, I just prop on the stool right next to hers and I ask, do you fuck on first dates? Does your dad own a brewery? Could I feed your tits? Or would you show them to me? Cause you got a nice head and you look pretty honest. So me face will be leaving in quarter of an hour. I'd like you to be honest. When you first meet a Sheila and the bullshit you gotta go through, like calling her up and telling her you love her when all that you'd love is just a screw. But she wants to hold hands and you to meet her old man and sit around for hours and talk. But Me new method is, you just cut through the shit and get down to the goodies straight off. Do you fuck on first dates? Does your dad own a brewery? Could I see your tits? Or would you show them to me? Do you sleep in the nick? Do you give head very often? If we can decide your place or mine, we can fuck off then. So the next time you see a good-looking Sheila and you'd give a week's pay to hold her, don't sit acting dumb, just front a full on and drop a few lines that I told you. This new method of mine might not work every time, but then again no method will. I've been spat at and slapped and kneed in the knackers, but then I got a few fucks as well. Do you fuck on first dates? Does your dad own a brewery? Could I see your tits? Or would you show them to me? If the answer is no, too many questions above, then be a good sport and give me the name of a girlfriend who does. You could see a blue was brewing as they eyed each other off, and the tension only mounted when Snaggy won the toss.
You break.
He said to Lofty as he chucked across the queue, and the tension in the pub just grew and grew.
I'll break, all right.
Said Lofty as he snapped the queue in half and flung it back at Snake and said,
you shove this up your ass.
Me nana give me that, said Snakey. Mate, you're fucking gone.
And the Feather Brain Championship was on. It was the front bar Feather Brain, non-title fight. Two blokes the size of buffaloes, big but not too bright, and no one give two knocks to go cheat who was wrong or right. But the front bar Feather Brain, non-title fight, no one seemed to know too much about their pedigrees. In that sort of place you didn't ask them sort of things. They said Lofty's from the top end, he was ugly, tough and mean. Used a welder's wire brush to scrub his teeth. And Snake was just plain ugly, where he come from no one knew. Reckon Rambo would have shit himself if Snakey told him to. And together they weighed half a ton in singlet, shorts and thongs. There was no cut home, but all the lights were on. The breeze near knocked me over when Snake threw the opening punch. It seemed to come from nowhere, I just heard this sickening crunch. I thought if any bastard lived through that, they're pretty fucking good. It was like a railway fiddler's hammer splitting wood. It slammed Lofty against the eight ball table, flipped it on its edge. But he just casually got up, walked around, then ripped off all the legs. Then one by one he smashed the cunts across Snakey's ugly head. If his brain weren't so well padded, he'd be dead. But Snake just shook his skull and blinked a bit and slowly looked around. Then chucked a right that would have knocked the war memorial down. And the force of it sent Lofty flying, crashing through the wall. Now there's a doorway where there weren't one there before. He landed ass up in the shithouse with his feet stuck in the air, with bricks and shit and broken glass and paper everywhere. And caked in that and crap, he ripped the dummy off the wall, and armed with that and fuck all brains went back for more. He slammed that dummy over Snakey's head, shattering it to bits, peppering them with porcelain and splattering them with shit. And there was teeth amongst the muck and shit. Whose they were you couldn't tell, but it looked like Lofty lost an ear as well. And Snake's right eye was swollen shut from where he'd cop one arse. Fair dinkum made it look as black as Ernie Dingo's arse. But with all the pieces
and end with all the blood and gore. They weren't as fucking ugly as before. There was flesh and hair and skin and bone and blood splashed on the wall. And them two bastards wallowing in it rolling across the floor. And the publican just scratched his balls, wondering, looking round, should he clean the bastard up or burn it down? Most blues you see turn out to be a win or loss or draw. But fucked if I've seen both opponents lose a fight before. And I heard Snakey say to Lopsy as they crawled towards the bar,
"Fuck the snooker, want a game of darts?"
It was the front bar feather brain, non-title fight. Two blokes the size of buffaloes, big but not too bright. And no one give two knobs a goat shit who was wrong or right. It's the front bar feather brain, non-title fight. It was the front bar feather brain, non-title fight. Two blokes the size of buffaloes, big but not too bright. And no one give two knobs a goat shit who was wrong or right. It's the front bar feather brain, non-title fight. It was the front bar feather brain, non-title fight. Two blokes the size of buffaloes, big but not too bright. I'm a fairly normal man, but a 10 I reckon's every man's desire. So with that playing on me mind, I went out to try and find a perfect 10 to help put out the fire. Found this joint I'd heard about, where the sheilas all hung out. I paid me dough, they stamped me hand, and I went inside. But I didn't see no 10s, must all fucked off by then. Oh well, hang around a while, check out the 9s. There's a 9 sat at a table, so I went over, said g'day. But you just sat there staring doe-eyed at the stage. Must be a groupie for the band, no telling what she's caught from them fucking corpses. I'd be better off with an 8. Now this A-grade body, pretty face, but these dago disco devs just ain't my style. And a dress look like she's stole it off a fucking toilet roll, and the makeup has been slapped on with a trowel. I'd even settle for a 7, because I've had a beer or two, and I'm prepared to bend the rules a little bit. And I'll try and overlook the fact she's not all that good looking, as long as she gives head, got big tits. Can hardly see their faces, fucking dark here in this. But in the darkness, even sixes look all right. And when I saw this one come past, I grabbed
it. Right, that's the end of the speaker again. Need to charge the speaker back up. And I think on that bombshell, I will end the video for now. I will carry on chopping this this building down because it's not needed. There's no bed inside. It's just a useless bit of building that as I can use for resources. So yeah, right, let's end my video then. I'm sorry there's not much to do in this video, but I will personally do better tomorrow. I got some ideas what I want to do tomorrow, so yeah, but for today I'm just gonna chop this down and be all good. So I'm gonna say thank you very much for watching. Please like, subscribe, share, hit that bell for notifications. And tomorrow we'll be back with some more Minecraft. And until then, I'll see you all again. Goodbye.